Fine time for sleeping. Get up.
Huh?
Get up.
Oh, I forgot. I have something for you. It's in my pocket. Go and see. It's only a card. Go and see. My black jacket.
For a wedding.
Mr. Sonal gave it to me yesterday. It's for his brother's wedding at Neroli.
We're going?
Of course.
We will sit in a bus and go. What will I wear? What will I wear?
This looks very nice.
What? My pink sari or my blue? And my gold earrings.
So nice. Indu, would you like to live here? It's so peaceful and beautiful. I think rents must be very low. It would be economical for us.
And also dull.
So you're a big city girl now.
I've seen enough of cows and fields and wells. I like to see many people and cars and buses.
Come.
Thank you.
I think you don't feel so well. When I was married last year, I also did not feel so well. You know, I thought, what should I do with a wife? I was quite angry. But you know, it's not like that at all. Not like you think. Only in the beginning. When you're first alone together, and there's never enough money. So much worry. And then when you come home, and there's your wife. And you don't even like her. You don't know her. How can you like her?
My mother used to cook this dal quite differently. You must learn from her when she comes. What is the matter? What is the use of sighing like that? You have nothing to sigh for. Sitting all day. No work. And you have a servant. Not that is much use. Only think of my position. It is I who should be sighing. Not you.
Do you think teaching in a college is a joke for me? So many boys in every class, and every day 9 to 5. And when you come home, there is no work. You see all those papers lying on the table? I have to see to them also. You're thinking of your home? Is that it? You're homesick? Homesick. I'm also homesick. You think I'm happy in this place? At least clear away all this. The home must be kept tidy. At least this much you must learn. Spick and span. You think my mother would have left these things lying about like this? Please remember. Spick and span.
And the clarification is given by the delegations of Ceylon, the UAR, and Pana, who placed before Parliament today. 26 Afro-Asian countries have conveyed their full support to us in the border conflict with China. Both governments have been asked to divert as much money as possible for agriculture under the Community Development Program. The President, Dr. Radhakrishnan, is now back in the capital after a day's visit to Calcutta. Both Houses of Parliament reassembled in New Delhi this morning after an interval of 6 weeks.
We consider the history of the Mughal Empire from the year 1526 to the year 1857. There is one salient fact which strikes us forcibly. What is that salient fact? Consider Akbar, Jahangir, Shah Jahan. Now we must consider some of Tatsam words. That is, words uncorrupted from Sanskrit. For instance, Ichha, Data, Mata, Naam. Kartar Singh, what do you know of Tatsam words?
Nothing, sir.
Can you please give examples?
Ichha, Data, Mata, Naam.
Very good, very good. Where are you looking? Huh?
We, sir?
Listening to your lecture, sir. What is that you're hiding?
Oh, this? Notes in your lecture, sir.
Please listen. All Tatsam words appear in Hindi without the Sanskrit case termination. Thus, these words appear in Hindi under the form in which they assume. Who threw it?
There was a lot of noise coming from somewhere.
My voice made no noise, sir. We were considering the glories of the Mughal Empire.
Mr. Prem Sagar.
Mr. Khanna, sir, we are working on Tatsam words. I was telling them about Tatsam words as distinct from Tadguru words.
I will not have indiscipline in my college. Is that understood? No indiscipline. Attention to our studies, our thoughts always on examinations ahead. That is the rule of our college.
Very good.
This is how a college should be conducted.
Yes, sir. Quite right, sir.
If any student is found guilty of indiscipline, severe measures will be taken against him.
Severe measures must be taken.
Work is worship. That is our guiding principle. Sit down. Copybooks open. Pencils out.
The Sanskrit root of our word mata is taken from matra. Who threw it? Huh? You. Threw out, sir? Sit down. Didn't you hear what our principal said?
Work is worship.
If you spend all your time in games, how will you pass examinations? Thank you. I've eaten and come.
I have to bring my food with me. I live so far.
Yes. Neroli is a long way.
I have to leave home at 6 o'clock and then cycle and cycle to get here at 9.
Perhaps there's a college nearer to Neroli.
It's not so easy to get jobs in colleges.
No. I was very lucky to get a job in this college. You see, it was through a friend of my father's. My father was himself principal of a college. In Angpur. Principal of a government college.
Of all wretched men, surely the idle are most so. Those whose life is barren of utility, who have nothing to do except to gratify their senses, are not such men the most querulous, miserable, and dissatisfied of all, constantly in a state of ennui, alike useless to themselves and to others. Mere cumbers of earth, who, when they are removed, are missed by none, and whom none regret. Most wretched and ignoble lot indeed is the lot of idlers.
It's on very fast. Perhaps electricity comes free so that we can run our fans at such a speed. The staff of this college has all the facilities. Mr. Khanna is too generous. I often tell him.
We are very grateful, Mrs. Khanna. You do so much for us.
Advantage must not be taken of people's goodness. Taylor, I want pleats. Here, here. Like this.
When my father was alive, Mr. Sonlal, I had no worries at all. I was just a student. Now they've married me to a girl. It's not easy to be a married man and support a wife and pay rent. And I miss my home very much. My mother and my sisters and all my friends. And my wife doesn't cook very well.
That's all. I want the curtains up by next week, when my guests come. Mr. Sohanlal, if you must eat your food here, please spread something underneath.
Excuse me, Mrs. Khanna. I am very careful.
We can never be careful enough.
Mrs. Khanna is very house proud.
Yes.
My wife is not house proud at all. Only yesterday I had occasion to tell her. I think she's not very intelligent.
She must be very young. What's her name?
Indu.
Indu? Indu's a nice name.
Do you think so? I like a name like Nandita or Nimmi. That is beautiful. There is a film star called Nimmi. Perhaps you've heard of her? I admire her very much. In Angpur, my friends and I would go see all her films. We even sometimes went 3 or 4 times. We knew all the lyrics by heart. Ae mere dil kahin aur chal, gham ki duniya se dil bhar gaya, dhoond le ab koi ghar naya. Ae mere dil kahin aur chal, chal jahan ho. Nowadays, I can't afford so much to go to the cinema.
the lover, sighing like furnace, with a woeful ballad made to his mistress's eyebrow.
Good morning, gentlemen.
Good morning. Sit down.
Today, I have a very pleasant duty to perform, to invite you to a tea party.
Excellent. Tea party.
Very good. Sunday at 4 o'clock in the evening.
4 p.m. sharp.
Oh, yes. Of course, the ladies are invited, too.
I shall certainly convey this good news to Mrs. Chadda as speedily as possible. She will be delighted.
He means we must bring our wives. But my wife may feel very shy to come. It'll be very difficult for her to make conversation.
Ladies are usually shy.
An hour's relaxation, now and again, braces the muscles of the mind.
No, not there. Here.
An hour's entertainment in the midst of a busy schedule is like a refreshing bath on a hot day.
Excellent image, sir. Excellent image. A refreshing bath on a hot day. A very striking image.
Very striking.
And so we return to our labors. Revived, refreshed, relaxed.
Mahesh Singh, bring the tea.
Ah, yes. I think we're all ready now for the tasty dishes Mrs. Khanna has prepared for us.
The whole morning I was in the kitchen. It's no good leaving things to servants. What are you waiting for? Hand them round. Take. Eat. No, eat. What else did I make everything for? I use only the best key for all my preparations. You'll just taste the difference.
I am particularly happy today to welcome the ladies among us.
Now our women stand side by side with us to aid in shouldering the burden of national development.
We must all, men and women alike, contribute to this national development.
India, wake.
People with colds should be careful to cover their mouths when they cough. Go on, eat.
We must not forget the cultural side, too. Our 5,000-year-old tradition of sculpture, dance, and song.
How pleasant it would be to hear one of our beautiful Indian songs from the lips of one of these fair ladies.
You sing.
No, you sing.
Please, you sing.
Come on. What is there to be shy?
No, sorry. I have cold today.
No excuses. Come on.
Now, now, what's there to be shy of?
Gaddiya gayi station te parahat ve maya parahat ve babu sanu maya ve khande hare diya panj.
Oh, I have forgotten.
Excellent. What is the music we have in our country? It flows from the heart. The earth is colored with the light of the young dawn, and the eyes of the skies are red. Oh, brothers, the eyes of the skies are red. Mridu samir mein naache tarani, nadi bajave taal, bhaiya nadi bajave taal. Shok nadi mein deh tari ko chalana seekho, chalana seekho. Shok nadi mein deh tari ko chalana seekho, chalana, moh chalana, moh chalana seekho, jald katenge din.
Get up! Is this the time to sleep? What is all this mess? Go, put on the fire. Can I come in?
Yes, yes.
Come in. Sit down. Be quite comfortable. What a pretty color. Oh, it's a pullover for my Ramesh for the winter. I think this color will be very suitable for him. You are also fond of knitting?
I like it very much. At home, in my father's house, my sisters and my cousins and I, we used to knit so much. Here I've done no knitting. Wool is so costly to buy.
Your husband doesn't give you sufficient money for your household?
Ramesh, get up. He gives. But what does he understand of what things cost?
Men are like that. They don't understand.
Give me money for the picture this afternoon, Ma.
What a fine bag. Every day you grow bigger and stronger. God bless you.
1 rupee, Ma.
Yes. Oh, where is my money? Can we deny anything to our children?
One more, Bhima.
Look.
My mother, just the same. Anything I wanted, bangles, saris, sandals, everything she gave. But my husband, he never does. That is the way it is.
When a girl is married, she thinks and thinks of her father's house. And tears come to her eyes. Oh, no. No, no. No.
Why must Mrs. Khanna's guest stay in our staff room? Oh, it's very hot. My house is also very hot. The fan's broken. Repairing it will cost 10 rupees. How to manage that in our salary? 180 rupees a month. What is that these days? I think we must all go and ask Mr. Khanna for increment. With families to support?
I have my own family to support. And also my brothers. He died of fever 3 years ago. 4 little children.
Oh, it's terrible. I will go and ask for raise in salary. Mr. Khanna must be made to understand our positions also. Is it right for one man to have everything and another nothing? It's not right. It's wrong.
Ah, come in, come in. You see me enjoying my breakfast. Very important to start the day with a good breakfast. Stomach juices must be encouraged to flow, or else the system gets clogged and nasty indigestions follow.
Please, be careful of my carpet. It's just come back from the dry cleaners.
There are certain rules of physical hygiene that we must all strictly follow. Only then can we develop a healthy mind in a healthy body.
It's bad for too many people to walk over a carpet.
A healthy mind in a healthy body. That is the ideal that we must hold before us.
Mr. Khanna, sir. Mr. Sonna lives in Meroli.
Eat. Why let yourself be disturbed?
It is a long way, sir. He brings his lunch with him. He has to leave his home at 6 in the morning on his bicycle.
Cycling is very good for the development of the leg muscles. Fine exercise. I always enjoy it.
Mr. Khanna, sir, in the Shastras it is written, it is better to be dead than poor. Life is a hard struggle, sir. And it is the duty of those whose struggle is lighter to give a helping hand to those for whom it is very hard.
Very good thought. I like to hear people engage in such philosophical questions. I, too, am interested in these questions, given them a lot of deep thought. Hand me my shoes.
Why are people encouraged to come in here? The principal's living quarters should be kept separate from the college. Some peace there must be.
It is good for a young man to engage himself in philosophical questions. Keeps the mind fresh and active for his work.
You can take this towel to my guest room. You can hang it on the rail near the window.
Thank you.
I sit alone up there all day. And then he comes.
You must visit us often.
I also feel ill. I don't know why.
You feel ill?
Yes, in my head. I feel very dizzy. Oh. Everything goes round and round, like this.
Ramesh, just go. Just go and see if the windows are shut in the bedroom. Go, son. It looks like rain is coming.
I'm in a hurry, Ma.
Go, son. You are my good son. God bless you. Go. Listen. I think, child, I'll have to take you to a lady doctor.
Doctor? Oh, no, it would cost money. My husband, he...
The windows are shut. Why did he send me for nothing?
Today I took your wife to a lady doctor. Just go upstairs. She has something very nice to tell.
Hey, what's the secret? Let us also hear.
Shh. God willing, soon there will be three of you. Go, go to her.
Is it true what Mrs. Seigel said? Well, say something. But how can I support a baby? It is difficult enough for me. For you, it is easy. No worries. You don't care.
It's not my fault.
Then whose fault is it?
Yours. Who else?
Don't talk like that. It is very indelicate. Ladies should never talk like that. Where are you going? Huh? Where are you going?
Get water.
And this boy, he was again playing in the street. Is there no work for him in the house?
We don't need a servant.
Huh? What do you say? Don't need a servant? How will it look if you were to do the sweeping? The wife of a college lecturer. And you're very disrespectful. Is this the way to talk to your husband?
Mm-hmm.
Don't keep this on my table. I'll call my mother. She will teach you.
Yes, yes. You send for her. Then she can cook your food the way you like. When I'm gone.
Gone? Where?
Gone home. Of course I'm going home. Every girl in my condition goes home to her mother.
At the end. Not in the beginning.
At the beginning also. What do you know about it?
You're not going.
Of course I'm going.
I forbid it.
He forbids it.
At once I will send a telegram to my mother. At once. I'm going. Let her come. Then we will see how you talk to me.
Yes, yes. Go and send your telegram.
She will soon teach you how to talk to your husband.
Go and call her. She and you can be very happy together here. I'm going alone to the station. Please forbid me. Just forbid me. Go on. Say it. Say it. I forbid you.
I think she must have got the telegram by now. She'll be packing her things. When mother comes, it'll be much easier for you. I'm going now to see Raj. You know Raj? He's the boy who was in college with me in Angpur. I've told you about him. He's the one whom I see every Wednesday evening outside the Golchester cinema. You know, Raj will be able to advise me. He's been married for 3 years. And he already has a child. So he knows everything. But you must take something at least. You eat nothing all day. At least a cup of tea, huh? I'll make it for you, huh? I'll just bring it.
Don't you touch anything in my kitchen.
You must eat something at least. And especially in your condition, you must drink a lot of milk. I'm going now. Will you eat when I'm gone? The food's lying there, and it's still hot. Shall I bring anything from the bazaar for you? I'm going. What was so important that you couldn't wait till Wednesday? Now that you've come, you can sit down.
Namaste.
Bubbly, don't eat that.
Chee, 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 chee.
Bubbly, don't cry. Come to Uncle. Come, come.
She's a very naughty girl. All day you have to be after her. Come.
Have you got no work in the house? Going quack, quack, quack when we want to be alone?
Quack.
Take her inside.
What did you think?
Women can be very troublesome. You have to keep them in check. And the children too. You will learn when you'll have one of your own. That is exactly what I've come to talk to you about.
The milkman is here asking for his money.
Tell him to come another day. Why bother me?
He says he's waited long enough.
That is all it is in married life. Money.
For your pan and cigarette, there's always enough.
Money's my problem also. You see, now my wife, she's expecting a baby. And my salary is very low. Only 180 rupees a month. Why don't you ask for a raise? That would be very embarrassing for me. In government service, every year we get 5 rupees increment. I wish I could get a job in government service. It's not so easy to become a government officer.
You could take Bubbly for a nice walk.
Am I Haraya? They come like lambs. And before long, they are tigers at your throat. My wife won't even speak to me.
He's taking you now, my sweetie. Don't cry.
Do you think, you know, only to make my wife feel better with me, do you think I should buy her a present? Certainly not. There is no use spoiling women. Come. Ah.
Come.
It's very hot. Why don't you put the fan on?
Makes too much noise.
Don't you feel hot with so much hair?
What do I do? Cut it off?
No, no. Look, I've got this for you.
I don't want.
Only just look. Laddus.
Laddu?
Hmm. Very good ones. Made with pure ghee.
I don't want.
Just taste. Only once, huh?
Ow!
You're very hungry. Why are you so hungry?
You're not hungry. Only for sweets. Only sweets. Please take it away. You'll be ill.
No, no. Only one more, huh? Just one. Look, I will eat half, and you eat half, huh? You eat half.
Don't know how long for sweets. I want to eat them all the time.
Why didn't you tell me? I would bring it.
I think when women are, you know, like I am, they want to eat these things. I've heard like this.
Hmm. It's biological.
It happens to women.
Indu? Prem bhaiya, there is a telegram for you. No bad news, I hope.
No. It's from my mother. She's coming by tomorrow's train.
Oh, then it's a good news. At such times, the mother is needed. Oof! Is this a tonga or a bullock cart?
Chokra!
If anything breaks, you better take care. 15 hours I've sat in the train. It's no joke at my age. Now you be careful with that. Look, look, look what he's doing. It's your favorite pickle, my son. The mango pickle. I made it with my own hands. It took me 2 days. And I brought some of your favorite Akpur biscuits. The very best. 4 rupees a sale. See that you eat them. How much did you give him?
1-4.
1 rupee, 4 annas? It's robbery. You should have given him only 8 annas.
She's only 3 months.
When we were young and a woman was expecting 3 months, the whole world knew. We were so healthy. You don't have much furniture. Didn't they give you anything?
They gave us this bed.
One bed. Don't you remember what we gave your sisters when they were married? One bed.
She's tired after the journey. That's why. Keep it there.
Who's this? Your servant? I don't suppose he's been trained for anything. Can he cook? Hey, how do you make muligi roti? Say, quick, huh? I thought as much. Hey, Ram, hey, Ram. Well, son, it's good that I've come. I'll put everything in order. I'm afraid her people haven't taught her well. I can see what sort of a housekeeper she is. I suppose she's a modern girl. When they can't keep house, they call them modern. But you look weak. My poor son. My poor son. I did my best. If your poor father had been with us, it would have been different. But God's will. Oh, Ram, 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 Ram.
It's very late.
Go. Go and sleep, my son. Go, child. Sleep. Mario, Mario, Mario.
Yes, Ma.
What time would you make my tea in the morning?
At 6 o'clock.
I want my tea at 5, before my puja. Sharp 5. That time for married woman to get up? What does she think she's in her father's house?
You see, I didn't have an opportunity to ask him for an increment. We talked of so many other things. I told him you lived in Mehrauli.
You talked about me?
Yes. I told him it was very hard for you to manage. But I will ask. My father always said, do what you have to do, and do it with a will.
Coming, sir?
Yes. What is it?
Mr. Khanna, sir. Sir, I was thinking, sir, whether the Hindi class will start at 2:30 or 3:30, sir.
It's all written up in the timetable.
Mr. Khanna, sir. Thank you, sir.
Oil. I would buy new clothes for him. Such pretty shirts with embroidery. How nice he looked. How are you holding it? Give it back to me. You're spoiling the picture.
You must be practical in matches. Is this all the pakoras you get? but I'm thinking of them all the time.
You must ask for a reduction in the rent. 80 rupees a month is too much.
I know.
How these people pester you?
But if I ask him, he will only say no.
Go away!
Perhaps I can try. You know, my landlord, Mr. Seigel, he's not such a bad man. And Mrs. Seigel also. They're very kind people.
What? You have paid? Why encourage them? When you'll have a baby of your own, you will learn not to be so easy with your money. Now I must go. I've got to get the medicine.
But just a minute. You see, I want to talk to you.
How much?
12 annas, sir.
I'm paying.
No, it's all right. No, I'll pay.
Again, you're paid. This is very bad. Let's go.
Perhaps if you could talk a little while longer. You see,
I have told you before. I've got to get the medicine, go to the dry cleaners. Sometimes you're very troublesome. Come.
You know what I'm doing? I'm becoming. I'm merging. See? This is the sky. And this is the earth. And this is I. I'm in all things. And all things are in me. Feel me. Just feel. Here. Get it? That's cosmic energy. Terrific. I mean, where are such ideas born? Only in India. Fabulous. What a place. Look. What do you see? It's a finger pointing up from the earth, out, into eternity. India's always pointing a finger into eternity. Sort of. What a country. What wisdom. What patience. It is true. We have taken great strides in our national development. Development of the soul. That's the important thing. And you've known it all along.
We have our five-year plans, which will greatly enhance our material progress.
Material. You've said the word. Materialism. That's what's wrong with the world today. That's what we've got in the West.
We have our steel projects, which will rapidly increase the growth of our country.
Sleeping again. It's time for my son to come home. Have you got his food ready?
Everything is ready.
You should have seen me when Prem's father came home from college. I used to have everything ready. A clean sari. My hair nicely oiled with flowers. Every day. I used to be like a new bride again, waiting for him to come home. I should run here and there and look out to the window. Has he come? The least bit of noise. Is it he? He has come. Go and put the water for the tea. Sleeping all the time.
I started reading that for a small time ago. I love it here. Of course, it took me a long time to get here, but still, in our country, the agriculture is blossoming for it. Yeah, but everything seems to be growing here. Why? And I know I'll find what I'm looking for because, well, you grow souls here. The way we grow skyscrapers or sweet potatoes, you grow souls. Our steel output will be the basis of great industrial expansion.
You've got the soul, and we've got the flesh. By the way, I'm Ernest Krupp from Philadelphia, PA, the city of brotherly love. And I'll tell you something else.
Where exactly is Philadelphia?
Look at the beauty you have in India. The sunsets, the tigers, the women, the songs. Ta-da-ta-da-ta-da-ta. You know? You've got it all here. And what do you do with it? You mortify it. Mortify the flesh and grow souls.
It is written in our shastras that,
you know what? I like your face. Huh, I see something there. In your eyes. And in that light. Oh, I could tell it a mile away.
Just look at this. What does she think this is? Tea? She?
Where is she?
She's downstairs. Somebody comes to sell bangles, and she must run off to waste my son's money. And the mother-in-law is left sitting here alone.
She's buying bangles? I didn't see her.
My poor son. He works so hard, and all that she does is spend, spend, spend. She must be taught to be more careful with money and not waste it on toys and trifles.
जिसके हीरो हैं किशोर कुमार और हीरोइन है साधना
अमीन साहब
फरमाइए किशोर साहब
हीरो हीरोइन की बात है जरा सुर में कहिए ना ऐसे
एक था अब्दुल रहमान एक थी अब्दुल रहमानिया अब मैं हूँ एक मनमोहन
Why do you leave my mother sitting alone upstairs? Have you had a quarrel?
I don't quarrel. What do I do? It's you.
Shh. Quick, get us some more tea.
Broken pieces of bread and harsh words. That's the law for mother-in-law. No more tea? Finished?
She must be getting some more.
When we were young, what respect we paid to our mother-in-law. We danced on her words. Hi, hi, those days are no more.
Ma? Can I get you some samosas from the bazaar?
Bring them for your wife.
I don't want. See how she shouts?
Indu? What are you doing? Please come out. Indu! Indu!
Don't bother, son. It's all right. I know it. She grudges me the use of the bathroom. This morning, when I was in there, she banged...
But I didn't know she was in there.
She didn't know that you were there. It was a mistake.
Never mind, son. After all, I'm only the mother.
Ma, don't cry. Why should you cry?
Tonight, I pack my bags. Tomorrow, I sit in the train and go home. My daughter-in-law doesn't want me here.
Of course she wants you here. You don't know how much she loves and respects you. Indu, please come out. She wants to leave. Say something nice to her. Indu.
I'm going home tomorrow. I come to serve my children. But if they don't want me, it's all right. Let go.
Indu.
My family will be very happy to see me home again.
During the 200 years of British Raj. During the 200 years of British Raj, they taught us their tongue and in turn made us forget our own. This class is being disturbed. Is this a classroom or a playground? Can't you keep your students in order?
Mr. Chadha, I've given them an exercise to do.
You may have given them an exercise, but they don't seem to be doing it. The first duty of a teacher is to enforce discipline. Discipline and silence. Pin drop silence.
Further, in our consideration of the achievements and blemishes, blemishes of the British Raj, there are certain points which I now wish to clarify.
Why did you talk to me like that in class? How can you scold me like a schoolboy? I'm a teacher. I'm the same as you.
How dare you talk to me in this impudent manner?
I'm the same as you. You can't scold me.
How dare you, sir, raise your voice to me
and in front of my whole class? How will it look? What respect can
Your insolence shall be reported to the principal of this college. Mr. Khanna shall hear of this matter.
Mr. Khanna will know that it is not right for one teacher to scold another teacher in front of his class.
And he shall also hear of the lack of discipline in your class. I will tell him that you are not fit to be a teacher.
You would have told me afterwards, here in private, in the staff room. I would have welcomed a word of advice from an older colleague. I would have been grateful.
I'll lay this whole matter before the principal. I will have justice.
Mr. Chadha, what is the need of disturbing the principal?
Mr. Khanna shall hear of this whole matter. Justice shall be done for the phone.
Mr. Chadha, if you think that I've offended you, I'm ready to beg pardon.
I insist on an immediate apology.
Sir, I am apologizing.
Otherwise, I'll go straight down to the principal this very minute.
There is a misunderstanding. Mr. Chadha has misunderstood me. Mr. Sonla, please explain to Mr. Chadha that I meant nothing, that I have the very highest regard for him. That I respect him like a father.
I insist on an immediate and abject apology.
Yes, sir. I apologize. I'm sorry for what has been said. I beg your pardon. I'm entirely at fault.
Kitty, I brought a visitor.
Oh, isn't he nice? Isn't he a nice boy? What lovely eyes. What's your name, dear?
Prem Sagar, madam.
Isn't that a nice name? Prem. Lovely name. It means love, doesn't it? Love, that's what we all need. Divine love, spiritual love, every kind of love.
Don't make him shy, Kitty. He's a sweet guy.
Make him shy? Me? Darnest. You're not shy of me, are you, dear? Never be shy. Always remember we're all part of one another, all part of the eternal essence. Isn't it a lovely thought? You want a room, dear?
Come and live with us, Prem.
Come live with me and be my love, and we will all the stuff. A quotation, dear, from English literature. Won't you come in?
English literature is so rich. I wish you would stay here with us, Prem. This holy man said just three words to me. Just three. He said, Ernest Kropp, come. Just that. Ernest Kropp, come. It was fantastic.
I get some funny dreams sometimes. I must tell you about them. Perhaps they mean something.
Oh. Better not to know, Bobo. You might get a few surprises.
What sort of yoga do you do, dear?
Please, madam.
What sort of yoga do you go in for? Hatha yoga, Bhakti yoga, Satta yoga, this yoga, that yoga, one of the many yogas.
I don't think I...
Oh, but you should, my dear. We all should.
Listen, Prem. When I had that dream, I didn't think twice. I knew. I packed my bags. Goodbye, America. India, here I come.
I don't know why anyone should want to come to India. We are so backward. Let's get some life in here.
Who is she? Is she really Indian?
She lives next door. I wanted to teach her discipline, but I don't think she's ready. She's just a little mixed up, that's all.
But why is she wearing trousers? Look, she's smoking. She's smoking a cigarette.
You know something, Prem? I've been thinking I'd take a vow of silence. I know someone who did it once, and he didn't speak a word for 6 months.
It's a good way that, if you can do it, it seals everything in.
Splendid. Very interesting information. A jantar, I would say. Or perhaps even Gupta. 6th century A.D.
Are you sure you wouldn't like a cup of tea, dear?
Very interesting. Pure Gupta. Extraordinary.
Don't mind him, dear.
Not at all.
We're such a cozy group here. We're all united in our quest.
We find the same heads, the same features, the same formations, over and over and over again. Men die and sink back into the ocean, and then are born again. Continuity. The drone of continuity. Like the drone of the Sangpura.
Look, everybody! Look at me! I thank you, Sestri!
Where is Ma?
She's gone to the temple.
Indu, I met some funny people. An American. And a man who said I was like a statue.
I think you've drunk something out of a bottle.
There was a girl. And a mem sahab too. If you'd only seen them. And this girl, she was like in a funny film. She was dancing round and round and smoking cigarette. Yes, she was blowing smoke and dancing and shaking herself. And her feet were going up and down and
up and down and up and down.
This?
No, not like that. Yes, like that. Going round and round and blowing smoke.
So this is how you behave when I go to the temple to pray. Today I'd offered special prayers for you. To bring blessings to this house, for your service. Here are the fruits and flowers. What is all this giggling and laughing about? Is this the way for a married woman to behave? I thought you came from a good, respectable family. You mustn't encourage her in all these things. You must be strict. She's now the wife of a college lecturer. Her father-in-law was the principal of a government college. You must teach her respect. She must remember all these things.
What are you doing? Why are you taking these things out? Are you packing something? Where are you going? But you can't go.
Can't go? You'll see tomorrow, 11 o'clock train.
Indu, please listen to me.
I've listened enough to you and to your mother.
Indu, please, look. Mother is old and old people are sometimes difficult in their temper. You must not mind her.
Oh, let her be. Let her sulk and cry. You come here.
Go to her.
Indu.
Best quality, cheapest price.
How much?
Rupees 30. See this. Rupees 25 only. Then you can take this blouse, please. This is rupees 4 a yard.
4 rupees? Oh. Really, you shopkeepers are all the same. Only to swindle money out of people's pockets. Are you buying for your sister?
No, for my wife.
Why do you show such stuff? Bring down that.
This red one.
What color will suit your wife?
I don't know.
He doesn't know. Is she dark or fair? He doesn't know if his wife is dark or fair.
He knows, only he won't tell us.
Show him the best you have.
For a pretty fair girl, pink is best.
Or lilac.
Yes, pink. Like this.
Have you been married long? Any children?
4 rupees 4 annas.
What 4 rupees 4 annas? The correct price is 3 rupees a yard, not 4 rupees 4 annas.
But I'm selling at cost.
You pay him 3 rupees.
Because you are such a good customer. Thank you.
You come, my son. See what I've prepared for you. Today you'll have a meal which you'll remember for a long time.
Ma, where is the meal?
Gone away.
Do your work. Who's after the kitchen in the middle? Pulao with peas, aloo ka bhutta, dal, mooli ki roti, mint, raita, all your favorites. Wait till you taste them.
Why did you go away? What hurt did I do that you had to go away from me? When are you coming back? Already you've been gone 3 weeks.
Wonderful
for you.
A surprise.
You see. Thank you, ma'am. You see, in the beginning, I didn't care for her. Now I miss her very much. I know it's bad to think of anyone so much. But I can't help it. All the time I see her before my eyes. When I speak, it is to her I'm speaking.
Perhaps you would like to come with me to a place where I sometimes go.
Where?
Someday soon I'll take you there.
I'm going out, Mother.
But you've just come.
It's very urgent.
But at least drink your tea.
I have to see a friend of mine. An American friend. His name is Ernest.
Go, my son. Go. Who am I to come in your way?
My dear friend, you're not an individual. You're part of the ocean of eternal continuity. What is this ocean? The absolute, the infinite, the eternal. The splendid monument. It is indeed very nice. Pure Jaipuri, of course. But I have a theory. Yes, a little theory. Come this side, please. Come over here. Look, you see how the world mountain heaves itself into forms comprehensible to man? 5,000 years of man and nature. Dig. Dig deep into this ancient rocky heart.
Excuse me. I came to see my friend Ernest.
Oh, hello, it's you. Have you come about the room? I could let you have to be cheaper if you're short.
Is Ernest here? I've come to see him.
He's meditating. That's always the first step, isn't it? Meditate. Concentrate the mind. Allow the eternal essence to knock at the door. I don't suppose he'd mind, though, if you went in. He's in there. Do go in.
Thank you.
Are you sure you wouldn't like to see the room?
No, thank you, please.
Prem! Guess what happened to me? I had an experience. A light came, a radiant light. I was sitting here in this very room in a lotus pose when suddenly, just here, and I'm coiled, up and up. And when it got to here, Wham!
Yes. Ernest, I wanted to speak to you. You see, I also have a problem.
A spiritual problem?
No, not quite spiritual. You see, my wife has gone away. And I miss her very much.
Non-attachment, Prem. That's the answer to your problem. Non-attachment to the things of the world.
I know. But I miss her very...
What is the world? I'll tell you. The world is Maya. The world is illusion.
I know. But she's so...
The world is a shadow. How can you attach yourself to a shadow? Only the infinite is real. Only the eternal. The essence. That's the answer. The essence. Just to catch a drop of it. Just a little drop.
Any letters?
She doesn't write.
Your shirt's torn. When she comes, she'll make one for you.
You're old and nobody wants you, it's better to die.
Ma, please.
When you're young, it is so different. You have your husband, your children, your home.
But Ma, you still have us. All of us. She, Kanta, Moini and I.
Your sisters, God bless them. They're all married. They have their homes, their husband, their children. What need have they of me?
Of course, they have great need of you. And I also.
You have your wife, son.
What wife can ever take the place of a mother?
No, no, no. Your heart is with your wife now, son. So be it. God's will. When you're old, you must expect this.
Ma? I bought it yesterday. I wanted it to be a surprise for you.
Why spend money on an old woman like me? What should I do with such finery? It is for some young girl, some young, happy bride.
It suits you very well.
You should bring such things for your wife, not for me.
I bought it for you.
कुटुंबतजि शरण राम तेरी आयो शरण राम तेरी आयो कुटुंबतजि शरण राम तेरी आयो ओ शरण राम तेरी आयो ओ कुटुंबत जी शरण राम तेरी आयो ओ शरण राम तेरी आयो तजगढ़ लंका महल और मंदिर तजगढ़ लंका महल और मंदिर नाम सुनत उठ धायो नाम सुनत उठ धायो ओ कुटुंबत जी शरण राम तेरी आयो ओ शरण राम तेरी आयो जन्म जन्म के मीठे पराभव हो जन्म जन्म के मीठे पराभव राम दर्श जब पायो राम दर्श जब पायो राम दर्श जब पायो राम दर्श जब पायो ओ कुटुंबत जी शरण राम तेरी आयो ओ शरण राम तेरी आयो ओ कुटुंबत जी शरण राम तेरी आयो ओ शरण राम तेरी आयो
Eat, boys, eat. Enjoy all the good things given us.
If you bring sweets like this, you can come every day.
Scoundrels. But these scoundrels are here day after day, just to hear the name of God.
I too would like to hear the name of God day and night. Often I think I could start from the beginning. I too would devote my whole life.
And what's stopping you now?
What can I tell you? What do you understand of duties which eat up a man's life so that it's no longer his own?
Sage, I am aware of those duties. They do lie heavy on a man's soul. But let God touch you once with his love. Just once. And you'll be free of all your duties and all your world.
I shall leave everything. Tomorrow I will come to you.
I think you're making me a declaration. My boy, you're married. You have a wife. And children also, perhaps.
What do I care about all that?
You are a householder. You have still work to do in the world.
Tomorrow I will come to you.
We shall see.
Hello, Prem. Where have you been?
I've been to see a Swami. Now I know the true way.
Gently.
There is only one way. To give up everything and turn to God. And to pray.
It's true. Nowadays, people neglect their religious duties.
We leave it to our wives to go to the temples for us. We'll get holy through their prayers.
No, we must all pray. We must all chant his name. Only then will he come to us.
You must take Indu to the temple. You must both go and make offering for her safe delivery.
Prayer can be said everywhere, not only in the temple. The heart must always be full and overflowing with prayer.
As soon as Indu came home this morning, I said to her, Indu, did your mother take you to the temple?
Did you have a good journey?
The train was a little bit crowded.
Sometimes it's better to be in a crowded train than alone in an empty one. Was it hot?
Has my son had his tea?
Thank you, Ma. I don't want any. Indu, did you eat many sweets at home? Do you remember the day I bought those laddus?
See what my son has brought for me? See? It's a very pretty color. He's a good son. He has great love for his mother. Sir?
Yes, Ma?
I'm asking God to give you health and wealth.
Thank you, Ma. Mohini, I hope you are well.
And your family also.
And your family also. I think mother is not liking the heat here. I think you must call for her to come there. Tell her you need her.
Please send a telegram.
No, no. Mother will be very frightened if she receives a telegram.
Tell your sister say it's for something nice.
And did you hear? I'm asking him to give you a son. A good boy like you must have nothing but sons.
Is it hurting you very much?
He moves sometimes.
You look pulled down. You're not well?
I'm okay. But I think I failed. I mean, in the spiritual life. I just can't seem to find what I'm looking for.
For the spiritual life, one has to give up everything.
But that's what I've come to India for. To give up everything.
There is a Swami. He's a very good man. And a sincere man.
Everybody's sincere. But not many seem to get anywhere.
Do you want to come with me and see him?
All those people are fakes.
Sure, I'll come. Why not? I'll try anything once.
No, not like that.
You know, once there lived a man, a simple good man. He was a householder with a wife and children. He was fond of them too. But he had to work very hard to provide for them. One day he said, "Oh, I'm so tired. Always work, work, such hard work, only to eat." So he was tired. And he said, "I will leave the world." He went into a forest. It was dark. And wild animals were there. He went further in, and he was afraid. But he thought, if I go a little further, I shall find what I'm searching for. So he went deeper and deeper into the forest, till he saw a light in the distance, and he knew that what he was searching for was near. But he was afraid, and said to himself, "Not yet, not yet." He thought of his wife and children and was suddenly overcome with a great longing for them. He turned round, turned his back on the light and went home to his wife and children and carried on with his work as before. Sometimes he still thinks of the light. He knows it is there and will always be there. One day, perhaps, he will go out and search for it again.
Mandir suna, deep bina, deep hai suna, te
दिल बिना कहत कबीर सुनो भाई साधो जग सुना एक राम बिना जग सुना एक राम बिना एक राम बिना Ah, I see a new visitor.
He's from America, my friend.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going, Swami. I'm going to look for it, for the light. I'll give up everything.
Everything?
Everything. Everything, Swami. I'm going to look for it.
All right. Then go and look. And you, my boy, when are you leaving the world? Not yet. Not yet. Never mind. Don't look like that. You're a householder now. When those days are finished for you, perhaps you'll think of me again. I shall always be here, waiting for you.
I'll be just like that man in the story. Only I won't turn back. When I get to the light, I'll walk right into it.
I think my wife will be waiting for me at home.
I'll find it. I'll find the light.
It's come.
What?
The telegram, of course.
The telegram's come?
Mm-hmm.
Why?
Sam? Just see what your son is doing.
Shh.
Mom, what are you doing? Where are you going?
See what your sister has said? I must leave by tomorrow morning soon.
Please come immediately. Nanda's betrothal to be made. Presence urgently required. So you have to go?
What can I do, my son? You read what she said. Presence urgently required. What's the law of these things? A child's betrothal.
But if she needs you, you must go.
Forgive me, my son. I know you also need me. I've seen with my own eyes what great need you have of me in this house.
But if her need is greater, tomorrow I will take you to the station.
No, son. I can go when I can.
No, Master. Tomorrow I've got a holiday.
Why should you travel? No, son. I can go.
No, well, how will it look?
How much have you paid him?
One.
It's no good spoiling these people. My son, I've been staying with him. He's only been married a few months. You're good.
I think the train is starting.
Yesterday, I got a telegram from this boy's sister. Her daughter is getting married. She's written to say your presence urgently required.
It's starting.
I leave him with a heavy heart.
I think this man wants his cups.
Goodbye, son. God bless you. Take care of yourself.
Don't
worry.
Goodbye, ma'am.
Thank you.
Takeda Hotel and did the same thing there.
Isn't it time you come from college every day?
Yes, we have late classes nowadays.
Come on, join us. Have a hand.
No, thank you very much. I've never learned how to play cards.
Oh, no. No playing cards, no drinking. How do you spend your time?
So the proprietor of Takeda Hotel said to him, is this the way to behave? What if you went to Gaylord and did like that?
Mr. Seidel, I would like to talk to you.
Lalaji said to him, I have been to Gaylord. And you know what they said? They said, if this is what you want to do, then go to Takeda.
Whenever I try to ask them, they always talk of something else. Mr. Khanna tells me how to keep healthy. Mr. Seidel slaps me on the back and says, come and play cards. If only I could get a chance to talk to them, I might
Must you do that now?
Then when?
You must write them a petition.
How can I write a petition? It will look bad.
I'm only giving you advice. You can take it or not. As if I haven't got enough troubles of my own.
You have a nice place?
Of course, for 8 rupees a month, it must be a nice place.
Please come and visit us. Perhaps you'll have a meal with us someday.
Is your wife a good cook?
Let us talk. Who asked you to speak in the middle?
What should I say in that petition?
You must start. Gracious sir, I wish to submit for your kind attention.
Gracious sir, I wish to submit for your kind attention that though I've been living in your house.
But this also you wrote in the other letter?
That letter was for Mr. Khanna. This is for Mr. Seigel. Now please don't disturb me. These flies.
They're very bad. We must get some DDT. I tender you all the respect and honor which is due our elders, your obedient servant,
Prem Sagar.
Why do you write obedient servant? You're not a servant.
It is the way of writing. How stupid you are.
Only you are very clever.
Quick, get me 2 envelopes.
Every afternoon, when her husband was in office. And every day between 2 and 4. And the children were in the house all the time. And what's more? What do you want?
I've got this letter.
Put it here.
It's for Mr. Khanna.
This is what you have to put up with in a college. All the time these people coming here to bother you. Give it to me.
But it's only for Mr. Khanna. Please don't read it.
Very fine. Always to take advantage of Mr. Khanna's generous heart. Rupees 180 a month is a very small salary. Therefore, I beg for increment. Mr. Khanna is too good to them, but still they ask for more. Greed is a black sin. Take what God has sent you and don't anger him by looking always for more. Whatever you do for them, it's never enough. Go now.
Mr. Seigel, I've brought a letter for you.
Huh?
A letter for you, Mr. Seigel.
A letter for me? Whom is it from?
It is from me to you.
From you to me? That's nice. Sit down. Is it an invitation? Perhaps to a nice party. You see this bottle? 60 rupees it cost me. 60 rupees for one bottle. In the olden days, used to be just 15 or 20. No more.
Mr. Sagar, my salary is only 180 rupees a month.
60 rupees for a bottle. It is so with everything. The cost of living has gone up terribly.
That's exactly my point. It's very difficult for me to make ends meet.
It is so with everyone. Everyone has his troubles and hardships these days. 60 rupees for a bottle.
If you could reduce the rent by 10 rupees.
And do you know what I pay
my
for
tea? My friend pays only 25 rupees a month.
Sugar, 1 2 a year. Rice, 1 4 a year. Terrible, terrible.
If I could only have a place for 50 rupees a month.
Eggs, 2 rupees for an acetus. Oranges, 3 rupees a dozen. Apples, 4 rupees a pound. Scatters, simply scatters. Milk, 12 rupees a pound. Bread, 10 rupees a pound. Tea, 4 rupees a pound. Meat, 2 rupees, 8 and a shilling. 2 rupees, 8 and a shilling.
No one cares. You'd think people would want to help you if you're young and have only just started out in life. But no one cares.
What does it matter?
The world has a very hard heart.
So let them. What does it matter? We will manage.
You're crying. What is there to cry? So let them all go. I am here. You are here. Don't do it. Just once let me see you smile. Only once. There. You are happy. Say it. Say, I am happy. Of course you are. And I also.